Hello and greetings. This is Dr. V.C. Sontake, and I am the course faculty for the course Energy Conversion 3. In this video, I am going to explain about the atmospheric jet engines, also called as air breathing engines. So, objective of this video lecture is to explain construction and working principle of turboprop engine. So, let us discuss about the turboprop engine. They are also called as prop jet engine. So let us first discuss the construction. So construction of the turboprop engine is shown in the figure. It consists of a propeller, gearbox, where some reduction gearing arrangement is there to reduce the speed, high speed of the turbine to the lower speed of the propeller, suitable to operate the propeller efficiently. Then there is a shaft which is connected to the compressor and to the turbine stages. Then diffuser, compressor stages, combustion chamber, turbine stages, and propelling or exhaust nozzle, and all these are covered by ducting. So turboprop engine in principle is also similar to turbojet engine, with the only difference of propeller. Turboprop engine is having two more components, that is propeller and gearbox. Another difference of working in case of turboprop engine is that in case of turboprop engine, most of the air, incoming air or atmospheric air, is made to flow over this propeller fan. And while flowing through this propeller fan, the incoming air produces most of the thrust required to propel the engine. Only few percentage of the atmospheric air is made to pass through diffuser, compressor, and combustion chamber, where the high pressure, high temperature gases are generated. Now, in contrast to the turbojet engine, the turbine of the turboprop engine consumes almost 90% of the 90% of these high pressure and high temperature gases to expand in the turbine and to produce the work output. So work output of the turbine of the turboprop engine is more than the work output of the turbine of the turbojet engine, because turbine of the turboprop engine has to drive compressor as well as propeller shaft. And after this, very few energy is left in the hot gases that are expanded in the propelling nozzle to produce thrust. So in case of turboprop engine also, thrust is having two component: thrust produced by the propeller and thrust produced by the hot gases from the propelling nozzle. So basically, in case of turboprop engine, it is the propeller which is generating the thrust. So question comes, or let us try to understand, how do the propellers generate thrust? So when a propeller is rotating, it sets up a pressure lower than free stream pressure in front of the propeller and higher than the free stream behind the propeller. For example, if a plane with turboprop engine is moving in this direction and atmospheric air is incoming from this direction, so what happens when the incoming or atmospheric air is flowing over this propeller shown in the black color. This propeller sets up, this rotating propeller sets up a pressure differential. Pressure of the air will be lower in the front side and pressure of the air will be higher in the back side. So a pressure differential is created, and this pressure differential basically generates the required thrust on the propeller, which actually propels the vehicle in the forward direction. However, downstream of the propeller disc, the pressure eventually returns to the free stream conditions. Now what happens? Though pressure differential is created on the front and back side of the propeller, but on the downstream of the propeller, that is in this side, pressure of the air returns to the free stream pressure conditions. But at the exit, the velocity is greater than the free stream velocity because the propeller does work on the airflow. But velocity of the air will be higher at the exit side here, because the propeller is doing some work on the air. Now we can apply Bernoulli equation to the air in front of the propeller and the air behind the propeller to calculate what is the pressure differential created by the propeller. So that way actually propeller generates the required thrust to propel the engine in the forward direction. Now why the propeller is able to generate the thrust? So answer to this question lies in the propeller twist. So as shown in the figure, propellers are twisted from propeller blades are twisted from root to the tip. So propellers are also of aeropile shaped like wings, but twisted from root to the tip. Blade angle varies from root to the tip. The blade angle is greatest at the root and the least at the tip. By twisting the blade, a relatively uniform angle of attack across the entire propeller blade can be maintained. If you closely observe the construction of the blades of the aerofoil, they are also of profile shaped, but they are twisted, and the angle of twist is more at the root, also as the pitch and angle of twist is less at the tip. Similarly, pitch is higher at the root and lower at the pitch. This twisting is done in order to maintain the uniform angle of attack of incoming air. If this twisting is not maintained, the angle of attack will not be uniform. Many times it becomes negative, and because of this, the root of this blade will come to stall while propeller is rotating and won't give rise to the thrust. Now propellers produce thrust in the forward direction instead of producing lift in the vertical direction by the wings. So that is the basic difference between propeller and wings. Wings produces lift in the vertical direction, whereas propeller produces thrust in the horizontal direction, horizontal forward directions. The simple purpose of a propeller is to convert the engine's brake horsepower into thrust. So in case of turboprop engine, the propeller is consuming most of the turbine power to generate the thrust to propel the engine in the forward direction. To accelerate an airplane, thrust must be greater than the drag force. By increasing engine power and propeller revolution, RPM, Air is increasingly accelerated across the blades of the propeller, creating a strong pressure differential at the front and back of the propeller, and thrust is generated, and this thrust pulling the airplane in the forward direction. So this way the propeller generates thrust and the construction of the blades are made in order to facilitate the generation of the thrust. Now let us discuss working and salient features of turboprop engines. So increasing the bypass ratio of a turbofan engine increases thrust. We have seen in case of turbofan engine, if we increase its bypass ratio, the thrust will increase. But in case of turbofan engine, there is a cowling which restricts to increase the bypass ratio after certain limit. So it makes sense to remove the cowl from the turbofan engine, and this will increase the bypass ratio. And when we remove the cowl of the turbofan engine, it becomes turboprop or prop jet engine. So turbofan and prop jet engines differ primarily in their bypass ratio. The value of bypass ratio is 5 to 6 for turbofans and as high as 100 for prop jets or turboprop engines. In a turboprop engine, the large diameter propeller handles a very large quantities of air. The mass of air passing through the engine is only a small fraction of the air handled by the propeller. Almost 95% of air is handled by the propeller to generate the thrust, and only 5% is made to pass through the different components of the turboprop and to finally generate the thrust. Thus, the turboprop engine can be regarded as a sort of bypass engine with a very high bypass ratio. Now, diffuser, compressor, and combustion chamber of turboprop engine function in the same manner as in the turbojet engine. However, in case of turboprop engine, the turbine extracts much more power than it does in turbojet engine, because the turbine provides power for both compressor and propeller. And after extraction of all the energy by the turbine, a little energy is extracted from the high temperature gas. So when all of this energy is extracted from the high temperature gases by the turbine, there is little energy left for producing jet thrust in the propelling or exhaust nozzle. Thus, the turboprop engine derives most of its propulsive thrust from the propeller, and they derive only a small portion, 10 to 25% depending upon the flight velocity, from the exhaust nozzle. Since the shaft rotation speed of a gas turbine engine is very high, a reduction gear must be placed between the turbine shaft and the propeller to enable the propeller to operate efficiently. The propeller thrust is provided by dual momentum change of air. The propeller increases the air momentum, and second, the overall engine from diffuser to nozzle provides an internal momentum increase. The sum of these two thrusts is the total thrust developed by the turboprop engine. Turboprop engines are more efficient than jet engines, but they are limited to low speeds and low altitude operations. Since their efficiency decreases at high speeds and high altitudes, in lower speed ranges, it is ideal because of its high efficiency, takeoff thrust, and the variable blade pitch operations. So, because of high bypass ratio, the efficiency of turboprop engine is very high. But they are used to operate at lower speeds at lower altitude, because when the speed increases, their efficiency and their thrust will also decrease. The old prop jet engines were limited to a speed of about Mach number of 0.62 and to altitudes of around 9100 meter. The new prop jet engine can achieve a speed of about Mach number of 0.82 and altitude of about 12200 meter. So modern prop jet engines can operate at a speed of Mach number 0.82 and to the altitude of around 12200 meter. The turboprop engine combines the merit of turbojet engine, that is low specific weight, small frontal area, simplicity and lower vibration, and the merits of the propeller are high power for takeoff and climb, high propulsive efficiency at speeds below 800 kg per hour, high thrust per unit frontal area, and good fuel economy. So turboprop engine will give you the advantages of turbojet engine and that of propellers. Turboprop engine applications. They are used mostly on smaller aircraft, and they generally fly slower and at lower altitudes. Learning outcome of this video. At the end of the lecture, learner will be able to explain the construction and working of turboprop engine. In next lecture, I will be discussing the construction and working of ramjet and pulse jet engine. So with this, I come to an end of this video lecture. Thank you for your passionate listening and kind attention. Happy learning.